Afternoon, folks. How is everyone? I hope you're doing well. You know, you're my people. You know I love you. Always want you to be the big three. Want you healthy, want you happy, want you safe. And you know what I want for me? Like, share, remind, comment, whatever. This sad day, man. We lost Jimmy Buffett today. Love Jimmy Buffett. I've been to a few of his shows. Oh, it was a great time, man. I am not a full-blown parrot head, but, you know, I've got a closet full of Aloha shirts and a ton of Lays and a bunch of hats. And, back in my more debauched days, it was always a good time. Had to go. Had to. So much fun. Those days are over, man. Sadly, Jimmy has left us. So we're not going to cover that here. I did that video already. What we are going to do today, though, is we're going to take a look at a nice beer from a local brewery. They are up north of me. They are in Williams. This is from Historic Brewing. I really need to get my hands on a can of their Pie Hole Porter, but it's about 96 degrees out and humid, and we're not drinking anything that heavy when it's this hot. So instead, we're going to take a look at Salt River Salt and Lime Arizona Lager, brewed and canned by Historic Brewing Company in Flagstaff. They do have a tap house in Williams. Next time I'm up that way, I'm going to have to swing by. Maybe we'll do like a live remote. We're looking at 4.8 for the ABV, 18 are the IBUs. This is a 12 fluid ounce can because they're not screwing us over. It is local to me. And they are an independent brewery. Close your eyes while sipping this beer and you might think you've been transported to a beach in Mexico. Our oceanfront property lager is transformed by the addition of salt and lime, creating a refreshing getaway in a glass. Well, we shall be the judge of that, shall we not, friends? The cure for anything is Salt River. It used to be. Now it is filthy and disgusting because too many people are absolute animals. It's where we used to tube out here. And it was always fun, you know, it was kind of like that kickoff summer thing, get a bunch of people together and some big old truck tubes and coolers and snackables, and you float down the river for 4 or 5 hours. Had a great time, but it got ruined. People leave trash, and the last time I was on there I saw diapers, and I'm like, that's fucking disgusting. Okay? Couldn't put that in a bag and just fucking take it with you. No. Animals. Anyway, I'm going to take a look at their webpage. I really need to change this up because people keep dipping out early. They don't want to listen to all my bullshit. So we're going to change this up and we're just going to shoot the beer early. People who want to watch it can watch it and get the information they need. And then afterwards we'll kick back, relax, put the feet up and shoot the breeze for a little bit. We did close your eyes. The color is light gold. The aroma is citrus notes of lime. The flavor is upfront presence of salt and lime with a biscuity and herbal finish. All right. That's what they give us. That's the dope. So let's get down to business. You know where we're at. 2 minutes. We're going to listen to some Jimmy in his honor because Jimmy, this is Pirate Looks at 40. It's him and Zach Brown on, I don't know, maybe Austin City Limits or something. I don't know. Not that it matters. It's Jimmy and Zach Brown. And crack it, pour it, temp, SRM, because they don't give us one. And we'll go from there. So if you don't want to do that, jump ahead 2 minutes and we'll catch up with you there. And here we go.
I have been drunk now for over 2 weeks. I passed out
we're in the middle of a song.
And I sprung a few leaks, but I gotta start with. Gotta go fishing down the rock bottom again. Just a few friends. Just a few friends. Thank you. with several a while. Though I ran them away, they come back one day and still can manage a smile. Just takes a while. Just takes a while. By the mother ocean, after all my years I found occupational hazard. My occupation's just not around. I feel like I've drowned, but I won't be found. I feel like I've drowned. Gonna get drunk or
adios, Margarita Man. Brutal, dude. Anyway, I don't know if it was Johnny or Boyd or one of the fellas hit me up on BitChute. It was nice enough to tell me that Jimmy had passed. I had just seen it, so I had known, but it's like, oh, brutal, man. A lot of people are never going to get to experience what a good time that was, although, to be perfectly honest, in the early 2000s, it had shifted and was not nearly as good as it used to be. It was Johnny 59. Johnny 59er was the one that hit me up. Thank you, John, by the way. Anyway, she is a very, very nice light lemony color. She is cloudy. That head came down nice, but it looks like she is going to lace well for us. Let's get the Biden. Let's go all Biden on it. The Biden up in there and see what's going on. She smells like a nice, clean lager. I get the grassy, but not the bready, and I do get a bit of the citrus on the nose. We are drinking her a bit over temp, you know me. I drink them 44 to 48 to make the aficionados happy. Beer like this in this kind of weather, I would like about 36. But that's just me. So let's slip her a tongue, see what she's got going on. Not bad. Salty, citrusy. It really overpowers the beer. Again, we're drinking a bit above temp, and I would like this to be a good 15 degrees cooler, but so she came in, tip of the tongue, she crests up, she rides the roof of the mouth, she rides the intradental zones. A little bit extradentally, another sublingual, nothing in the lower half. So yeah, salt and lime, basically what you're getting on here. And that burns out after about a second and a half, 2 seconds. But the beer never really kicks in, that lager flavor that I really like in my beers. Never really kicks in. You're left with the residual of the lime. So salt, lime, and then it's like a limey beer. And it there's not enough of the beer punch on the back end. So I would say it was over-limed. But that's just me. You do you. You might enjoy them that way. Not bad. 4.8, easy drinker when it's hot out. Flavor-wise, completely drinkable, so we're going to give her a 4. She's not really knocking my socks off, but I mean, it's good enough for the style, and you've seen me put salt and lime in my own beer, because sometimes, and especially out here where it's so damn hot, normally when you sweat, it evaporates instantly, and so you really do need to put the electrolytes back in your system. People routinely go into heat stroke out here because they're idiots and don't pay attention. That being said, so we're going to give her a 4. Would I drink her again? Sure. Would I buy her again? Yeah, maybe. I think I would go with their regular lager that they based this on. What did they say that was called? Oceanfront Property, from the song Oceanfront Property in Arizona. Guessing that's about when this beer came out, so it's probably 10 years old or so. And you go with that over this. She's warmed up even more still. Now she has really more citrus than anything else. Too much lime in my beer for me. Try it on tap? Of course. Next time I'm up there, I'm going to make sure that we swing by. Drink it again? Sure. Buy it again? Yeah. Try it on tap? Yes. Handed this to me out of the cooler. What would I say? I would say thank you very much. At least out of the cooler, I know it's going to be cold. Not a good warm beer. Lagers usually don't transition well to the higher temps. That's the darker beers. So the rule of thumb is always the lighter your beer is. The SRM on this, by the way, is going to be that real light lemon yellow, man. 6. 8. Let's go with 8. We'll give it an 8. Double ocho. Oh, no. Double quattro. The ocho. The lighter your beer is, the colder you want to drink it. The darker your beer is, the warmer you want to drink it. So, of course, there's a sliding scale in there. There aren't very many beers I enjoy above 60. Although, in the winter, again, you've seen me. I will just leave a six-pack out on the table when it's nice out, cool out in the 50s at night. Why refrigerator? That's right where I want it. So, that being said. R.I.P. Jimmy. Adios, Joe Merchant. We're going to miss you, man. Many a good time with you. And you, my friends, well, as always, thank you for coming. Stopping by. Spending some of your most precious time with me. Putting your eyeballs on my vanity project that is this. Hopefully you get something out of it. I gave you some information to work with. But you know, you're my people. You know I love you. I always want you to be happy, healthy, safe, honorable, dutiful, vigilant. Gray man, head on a swivel. Hot and handy. This is the way, my friends. I will catch you on the next one. Of 2 more millies to put up, too. So I think I'll just throw those up midweek, and then we'll go back to doing these on Thursdays. So, you know, like Tuesday for Tuesday in the kitchen with Millie or something like that. Anyway. Adios.